Hello everybody, myself Leela Howe, working as assistant professor in Bauxite College since from 15 years. Today I am going to teach you the concept of operations of cellular system. The operations of cellular system are mainly classified into four main types and a handoff procedure. The first operation is mobile unit initialization. Means initializing the mobile, starting the mobile. Second, mobile originated call, means a call which is done with the help of mobile. Third, network originated call, means a call which is done with the help of landline phone. Four, call termination, means ending the call and a handoff procedure. So, let us study all these operations in detail one by one. The first operation is mobile unit initialization. When a user sitting in a car turns on the receiver of the mobile unit, then the receiver will scan all the channels, selects the strongest channel and locks it. Means what? Whenever we turn on our mobile, then mobile receiver will scan all the cell sites nearby it. So it will select the strongest cell site tower and locks it. Means locking the strongest channel means selecting the nearest cell site, nearest tower. Cell site is nothing but tower. Okay, so this process of selecting and locking the strongest channel is called self-location scheme, which is user independent and used in ideal state of the mobile unit. This process is done automatically without participation of the user and without participation of the mobile unit, because both are ideal. Okay, so this is the process of mobile unit initialization. The advantage is that it will reduce the load on the cell site. How? See here, every mobile will scan only the nearest tower, nearest cell site. So it will reduce the load on the other cell site. Disadvantage, it does not give the information of mobile unit to the cell site. So here no location information of the user mobile unit is given to the tower, that is cell site. Now we are going to see the next operation, that is mobile originated call. Just I have now told you that mobile originated call means a call which is done with the help of the mobile. When a user dials or calls the call number which is stored in the register of the mobile unit to check whether the number is correct or not by pushing the send button. Means what? Generally what we do, we will call the called number which is already stored in our mobile. So in which part the number is stored? In the register. So, why we are dialing the number? To check whether the number is correct or not by pushing the send button. So, all this process of dialing the call number is nothing but we are making the request for service to the cell site. So, this is the request for service by mobile unit, that is mobile, to the cell site. After the receiving the request for service by the cell site will provide best directive antenna for voice channel, and at the same time it will send the request to the MTSO. So what is MTSO? Mobile telephone switching office. And this request is sent via, that is through the high speed data link. Then finally the MTSO will provide best voice channel for the call to the mobile unit. Thus, our mobile unit, means user mobile, gets connected finally to the MTSO. So, this operation you can easily understand with the help of following diagram. So, in diagram you can see your mobile unit. Mobile unit is nothing but user mobile. This is tower. You know tower, we also call it cell site. This is MTSO, Mobile Telephone Switching Office. And tower and telephone office are connected through wireless link that is called data link. So what happens whenever we dial the call number with our mobile number? So what we are doing? We are checking whether the number is correct or wrong. So this process of dialing the number and checking the number whether it is correct or wrong, it is nothing but request made by our mobile unit to the tower. So this is the request made by mobile unit to the tower. So what tower will do? It will provide the best direction of antenna to the mobile unit. Okay, and at the same time it will send this request to the MTSO office. So what MTSO will do? It will provide the best voice channel to our mobile unit. So it can have the connection between mobile unit and MTSO. So when MTSO provides voice channel to the mobile unit, both get connected. Third operation is network originated call. Just now I told you network originated call means a call which is done with the help of landline phone. When a landline user or party dials a mobile unit number, then the telephone office identifies that the dial number is of mobile, so that is wireless. So it will send this call or forwards this call to the MTSO. Then MTSO will send the paging message, that is short message consisting of mobile number, to some cell sites, and depending on the mobile number and searching algorithm. So what here done? Here landline user dials the mobile number. Telephone office recognizes this number is mobile number, so it will send the request to MTSO. And MTSO, what it will do? It will send the paging message which consists of mobile number to the some cell sites depending on mobile number and searching algorithm. Then the every cell site will send the page to the mobile unit. So finally mobile unit finds its own identification on the strongest channel, and then mobile unit locks the strongest channel. So what happens here? User dials the number from landline phone to the mobile unit. So telephone office recognizes this number is mobile, so it will send this request to the MTSO. MTSO will generate a short message which consists of mobile number and sends this message to all cell sites depending on searching algorithm and mobile number. Then each cell site will again send the page to the mobile unit. Finally, mobile unit gets its own identification code on the strongest channel, that is nearest cell site, so it will locks the strongest channel. You can better understand with the help of this diagram. See here, the user, landline user, dials the mobile number. Okay, so this is recognized by telephone office that the dial number is mobile, so it will send this request to the MTSO. MTSO means mobile telephone switching office. So MTSO, what it does? It generates the short message, okay, and which consists of mobile number, okay, and it will send this request to all the cell site nearby. Okay, so all the cell site, what it will do? They will generate the page. They will generate the page and send this page to the mobile unit. So what this page consists of? Mobile number. So this mobile unit recognizes its code, its number on the nearest cell site only. Other two towers are far away, so they will not give the information about the mobile number to the cell site. Okay, so here mobile unit will select the strongest channel. This is called nearest cell site or nearest channel. Okay, so in this way call is done with the help of landline to the mobile unit. This is called network originated call. Now fourth operation, call termination. Call termination means what? Ending of the call. So how the call is ended? When the mobile unit user turns off the transmitter, then a particular signal, that is signaling tone, is sent to the cell site. And both sides, sender and receiver, makes the voice channel free and disconnects the call between these two parties. So what happens when we are turning off our mobile, means turning off the transmitter. So what happens, a particular signal is generated and which is sent to the cell site. So what both the user will do, both the user means sender and receiver, they will make the voice channel free, which is given by MTSO. Yes or no? And in this way, mobile unit and MTSO gets disconnected and call is get disconnected. So this is called call termination. Last, handoff procedure. So what is handoff procedure? During a call, two parties are on the voice channel. I told you, whenever two users, sender and receiver, are talking, they are on the voice channel. They are connected with the help of voice channel. So when mobile unit moves out of the coverage area of the its cell site, then the reception of signal becomes weak. Then the present cell will request for handoff. The cellular system switches the call to the new channel of new cell site without either interrupting, that is stopping, and alerting the user. The call continues as long as the user is talking. Thus, the user does not notice the handoff process. Handoff was first used by AMPS system, then it was renamed as handover by the European system. This process you can easily understand with the help of diagram. See here, suppose I am standing over here, means I am making a call, and after making a call, I move away from this drawer to the end of the cell site. This is your cell site. Okay, so I am moving away from the tower, then what happens? The signal becomes weak. Reception signal from the tower becomes weak. Okay, so this cell site will send the request for handoff. Handoff means what? It will switch the call from this cell site to the another cell site where I am moving. Okay, so I am moving here to the new cell site. So I will get the channel from this new cell site. I will get this tower from the new cell site. And this process is done from moving from one cell to another cell without stopping my call, without alerting the user. Okay, and this is called handoff procedure. So handoff means what? Transferring the call from one cell site to another cell site without informing the mobile user, without alerting the mobile user, without stopping the mobile call. Okay, and this is called handoff procedure. Thank you. Here we have completed all the operations and the handoff procedure of cellular system. Thank you.